Welcome back. You're listening to Riddim FM, coming to you live from Kingston, Jamaica, broadcasting on the FM band at 102.1, 102.3, 102.5, 102.7, and 102.9 on the FM band. Remember that you can download the software, yes, and play Riddim FM on your phone. You can also access the station on the internet at www.riddimfmjamaica.com. www.riddimfmjamaica.com. All right, coming up right now, yes, is The Law and You. Where is the people's lawyer?
Where's the people's lawyer? Hi there, Mr. Darby.
The people's lawyer, he will never leave the people. Good morning, my friend Wendell Wilkins.
Yes, how are you today?
Well, I spent last night researching. Yeah. Because I say I know Wendell long enough. But when I read up enough about him, I'm going to go over the place. But check out your work in a church. I see I talk to congregation. We go all over the place. I see I educate people. I said, oh boy, Vernon, you must not just talk to people. You must check them out sometimes because they're not going to tell you the whole story. Because Wendell is a humble fellow. Yes, he's probably too humble. And he has been around. And for example, I think you still continue to work at the law school?
Yes, I am still at the law school. Yes.
What's your involvement there?
I teach civil procedure.
Yes.
First-year students.
But let me ask you something. I never want to teach adults, you know. I want to do something that. It must be difficult to teach adults who love to argue something. Whereas young persons who are going to become lawyers, can you just imagine?
Yes, well, it's good to teach a group of people who are willing to learn.
You know, yes, yes.
Because we are not too old or adult in our life not to learn new things.
And that is why, you know, Wendell, with this program, and we are pushing it, and I know you're helping us to push it, that is the only program of its kind in Jamaica. And it's a program, well, lawyers tell me they listen to it. Students, they listen to it. There's quite a bit that they can learn. You have students who are studying law. You have students who are studying IT. If they just listen to this program, there's quite a lot they can learn. Somebody out there who feeling not bright, we talk about things in such a simple way that anybody can understand. So we'll continue to, and we give thanks for persons like you who come on here to teach us, because many of us would only get teaching for you when we go to university. We don't even have the first paper for going to university. So we're happy to have you and ready to teach us.
The learning process is a continuous thing.
Yes. What's on your mind today, my brother? Yeah. By the way, before you get into that, you know, I saw myself, you can't find me see one document ago. I wonder if I real something, because when you're on the internet, you get all kind of rubbish sometimes. See, I've been driving. I don't know if you can guide me. When you have a lawyer here, you can guide me. I don't know if there are certain things I don't think, certain things I in court, you don't touch it. But I got something here about a notice of application for leave to apply for judicial review. And it speaks to the Commissioner of Police. Have you seen it and looked at it? And I wonder if this is a make up something,
yes,
fake something.
The one of the good things about our democracy,
yes,
is that it allows people to express themselves.
Right.
You can express yourself within the law, because you can't defame people. But if you have a grouse, there are many avenues to express it, you know. And there are persons who come on the radio and express their grouses. That is lawful, you know, once you don't reach the requirements of broadcasting, you know,
right.
And defamation and so forth.
Let me knock wood. I never have to apologize yet, and I've never said anything on air where anybody even hinted to me that it was libelous.
Right, and this is good for growth, this is good for edification, because we are not all fountains of knowledge.
Right, right.
Only us alone know what is right and what is wrong.
Right.
That is part of the democratic process. So apparently somebody has a feeling that the present commissioner of police is not fit for purpose for the job. And he's seeking to have him removed.
Whoa, yo, I hear you. I want him to pack his bags and go.
Yes, so that person is free to do so, and we'll see what happens in the court of law, whether it is successful or not. But there should be another avenue for that to be done.
Let me ask you something, Wendell. Looking at this, is this real or how can we check? I see it has a claim number, SU2023CV00. Okay, is what, a 733. Yes. Is that where you could go on the court site and put in that and see if that is a...
No, the present rules of the court don't allow any person who is not involved to access the document. So there is usually a requirement to get permission. If you are not connected with the matter, you're not a party, you're not a lawyer who has been engaged to access the file as such.
But that don't make sense to me. If you just promise have a case, aren't you free to go to court and sound and listen to the case?
Certainly you can.
So why we have a backcourt that a case between John Brown and Tom Sook, which we can learn from? Why we can't put up so we can look at it?
There are matters that are of a public nature that you can access in the court system there, the trials and so forth.
Right.
Other matters now that are of a private nature, involving sensitive matters of security, the economy, and children, those are restricted. And private matters between civil litigants that are in the chambers, those are also private, unless you're connected to the matter, you know.
It
is to protect the privacy, because, you know, there's a
family court and all that kind of thing. We have.
Right. So there's some measure of protection. But you can get permission if you ask and you have good grounds. Then you certainly can get permission to be there.
Right. But I just wondered, when I saw it first, because you have a lot of ridiculous things going around, when I saw it, I wondered. So basically you're saying, no, this seems to be a genuine thing.
I don't know, you know, because I've not checked it to see if it is.
Okay.
But what I am saying is that people are free if they are so disposed and the time and the money, and, you know, they can engage the court system, you know, and so forth, and the court will determine if it is a proper case and it is well founded.
What I wonder about that, I'll tell that not everything is the best interest of us all to go to court. You could lobby, for example, and if you get public support, you'll be surprised to know what public support can do.
Yes, certainly. And you see, in matters of judicial review, which you have mentioned, this matter relates to, there is a filtering process that you do not get permission to go ahead all the way for a hearing unless you get a preliminary permission to do so. So you have to get what is called leave or permission to move forward with your case. And you have to show a good case that is likely to succeed before you're allowed to go, because it keeps frivolous matters, what you call frivolous and vexatious matters, out of the court system.
Okay.
Everybody who want to create some kind of, you know, imagery and public relations and attract things to their attention. But there is not a genuine matter, and perhaps they are not even connected to the issue, but there they are, trying to bring the court into the matter, wasting court's time, which is very valuable, and other people's time. So,
Wendell, you say the time of the court is very valuable. Probably I have read it, and I would love to know the cost of some of these cases. The judge's time.
We just about to wrap up a case with in the criminal side of the court proceedings, which involves the trial of 30-odd members.
Yes.
Of a criminal gang. And it took many months of trial, many months of proceedings and lawyers, and in the background, you know, the police and
transportation, gas,
yes,
judges' time,
millions and millions of dollars.
So hold on, man. Might me not believe you when there. Some millions of. So hold on. I'm gonna pay for that now. You?
Well, the taxpayer, you see, It involves security of the nation, you know, and the safety of the citizens.
But guess what? Those who create the problem, they have to pay for it. I hope they can seize all their property, you know.
But who has created the problem? Who has created crime? Has an investigation been done? finger pointing?
That's the hook. And by the way, Vernon can be sitting around this microphone here, but he's helping to perpetuate crime by his policies, by his comments, by what he endorses, you know. So I hear you, my friend. So basically now, this document, because I was surprised when I heard on station broadcasting this information and treating it like what? Breaking news. I was a little bit concerned. Okay, there's nothing I love to do, because you just talk about wasting the time of the court, you know, with frivolous matters.
Yes.
Say, for example, two persons have a challenge, and this brother Naomi and Vernon just take him home and mash up in car. And you have to go court this, you're supposed to know, and you probably have the patience. You have to court this month, next month, 6 months after. I couldn't bother with that, Wendell. It's a waste of time and resources, and so I couldn't bother with it. No, it would seem to me, you know, that could be both civil action and criminal action, because if you damage a person's car, help me know, would that be a crime, right?
Yes, it will attract both sides of the classification of the law.
Yes.
Criminal side, because it's a wrong against the state.
Okay.
Public at large for malicious destruction
of property. Oh, I see.
There's the civil side, where if you have property and you have rights in that property, anybody who without lawful justification interfere with and damage that property, then you can seek money compensation and restraining orders and those things.
Suppose no, because I really think many things that go to court don't have to go to court. Suppose the both parties involved. They were just a little argument and something happens. Can the both of them come together and agree, say, all right, let me pay for the car and finish with it? Will the criminal procedures still?
That's the encouragement that is being given, albeit at a late stage now.
Yes.
Generationally, because we should be nurturing our young ones, the kids.
Yes, yes.
In the various educational institutions, that if there's a conflict, if there's a dispute, then they ought to resolve it by a certain means.
Right. But let me ask you though, if there is that and both parties agree, say, you know what, just pay me for the car and done with it, could the court continue with the criminal proceedings and same way? Or they would just...
Yes, if the police are involved and they go to the level of investigating and proffer a charge,
yes,
it will go to court, and in that circumstance, the parties can indicate to the judge that this is a matter that is not a serious crime that the judge must continue with, you know. It's not a serious assault, a minor infraction of the law. Then the judge can say to them that, okay, since it is resolved and you do not wish the matter to go any further, then, you know, the charge will be dismissed.
But suppose now, I decide, no. I was wrong and I decided, you know what, let me just pay the man for him care. Would it be seen as if I'm trying to buy out the case or anything like that?
No, because both parties would have gone before the judge and explained the situation.
Yes, yes.
That, for example, they are friends and it's a moment where, heat of the moment, this thing happened. And
right.
Compensation has been given, the other party is satisfied, they don't want the matter to go any further and so forth. Because remember now, the court is not there to resolve every single problem that
people have. Oh, that's why the courts have clogged up with all kind of rubbish sometimes. Everything we run going to court with it.
Yes, so there has been developed and it's been promoted by the Ministry of Justice.
Right.
Alternative dispute resolution.
Mm-hmm.
And police officers and the various police stations throughout the island have gone through training. And if there is certain types of criminal matters that are brought to the attention of the police, they can, you know, refer the matter to dispute resolution and so forth. You have a thing call restorative justice.
Restorative. Why do we use such big words? That's why I know for we don't understand, you know, when they're restorative. You know what that mean? You know, so well, we have to be careful. You just like how they are, the songs them, and then just use some catchy things. We just need to, when it comes to the law, and to do it in such a way so it catches on and persons will jump on board.
Yes. Well, sometimes we get these concepts from abroad, you know, and we don't change the terminology. We use the same terminology for consistency. But restorative justice is a process where the person who is accused of some criminal conduct admits to it, confesses, takes responsibility, and engage the person with the victim and associated person, because sometimes when a crime is committed, it affects not only the immediate victim, but family members and so forth, the community. So that person will engage all relevant persons and they come to a settlement and bring about peace and love and restoration and compensation.
Well, you know what I figure, when you go through that situation, we call it, your big word, restorative justice or whatever it is. You are saying, you know, that I'm just thinking, you know, practical, because I'm trying to be practical, you know. If me and a brother have a problem, I will slow now, I say, boss, all right, okay. We did beg, so I say, all right, fine, all right, take it easy. Give me $10. Yeah, we all right, fine. It means, therefore, that him agree, me agree, and we're good, and we can talk after that. But if you go to court and one win, you really don't win as such, you know, because me okay, things that my heart see me for you.
Yes, well, in family matters,
yes,
principle is well known that sometimes you have a problem within the family unit.
Right.
And by going through the process of a court where one person wins and the other person loses, it creates problems for the parties, especially when they are parenting.
Oh, yes.
Children, and it affects the entire family unit. And sometimes the dispute in certain subcultures in society continues on for years, and sometimes it becomes very criminalized. People decide to take things in their own hands because they believe that they got no justice out of the system, the formal justice system.
And then sometimes the killing continues and the war continues.
Right. So sometimes we want to use the more informal process.
Yes.
And you have a settlement there. So even in alternative dispute resolution, sometimes you can come to a conclusion that satisfies everybody better than going to court. Because going to court, you have just one kind of result. That you win or you lose.
Or you lose.
Right.
And I will tell you, Sam. I will tell you, Wendell, are you going to probably disagree with me being the lawyer? I'm going to tell you, you're going to court and fight on the issue. Nobody knows, everybody lose. Especially family business, everybody lose.
Yeah, so sometimes it's best to sit down and do counseling, and there are lots of trained counselors around that can assist. And sometimes a person just really wants admission and to in return give forgiveness, and the matter is finished with.
Done. Yeah. But somebody we stubborn, Wendell. Somebody we very stubborn, so stay there. By the way, Wendell, I'm going to go for the break shortly. But something happened, you know. You make me, I can have a little sympathy with the judicial system, because sometimes I've been fed up with it, you know. But we love the big word one, restorative justice. You make me a bite my tongue. Wendell, something happened recently, reported in the papers, that some persons were removed from a building. You had a nursing home, as you call it. It was a rented place. And I understand that eviction notice was given and the persons were just simply thrown out of the building. It was reported, I think, in the Observer. One man, for example, he has no limbs. I think he has no feet. And he was just thrown on the sidewalk. Now, my position is this. The court must have a heart. I would have expected something like that to have get a social. And I think when you have these things, a social worker should get involved. See the situation there, they probably advise that a government entity takes charge, probably take over those persons or something like that, but the persons were thrown on the streets. All right, we'll come back. I'd love to hear what you have to think, because I have this belief that it doesn't matter what you do, justice is only done when everybody feel that they have a little bit of the justice. So while you follow the law, which you must follow the law, if the people feel that the law has delivered an injustice to them, you have a problem. You're listening to Riddim FM. Of course, we're speaking with the people's lawyer, Wendell Wilkins, the man who has served this country for long. Not only have he making little money, he might have lived like me too, but he has spent his time helping others in the church, in communities, and also this program. Let's pay respect to a wonderful Jamaican, a talented Jamaican. And when he comes on this program to lecture, which he does really lecture, he talks to us, a university lecture is really giving of himself to the people of Jamaica, so you can have the benefit of the knowledge of from someone who lectures at the University of the West. I just want to thank him very much. Going to go for a break. We'll come back. Wendell, I want you to deal with that one when we come back.
Yeah,
okay,
sure.
My friend. So come back. I don't know if you're aware of the case, right? You're aware of that case where they were thrown out?
No, I'm not, but all right. I can deal with it.
All right, okay then. So come back. Don't move. My good friend, back with us again. Yes, you're listening to Riddim FM, coming to you live from Kingston, Jamaica. And of course, it's the lawyers here, the law, and you, Wendell Wilkins. And I just put to Wendell a situation which was reported in the newspapers where owner wanted his place, according to the reports. And someone had rented the place to have a nursing home. And the court ordered that persons be evicted. That's the report that I saw in the newspaper. And you, of course, with the elderly, you had persons there who could hardly help themselves. And my position is, did we set a social work out to find out what is happening? Did those who were in the place state that there were elderly persons there? I don't know. But to me, that was injustice dispensed of. No. So I'm biased, Wendell.
Well, first of all, we have to have all the facts, you know.
Right.
This is a problem with media reports.
Yes. We don't have all the facts.
What was put before the court, because it may have been a situation where a long notice to quit was given, months upon months, and extensions, and the operators of the business, which you say is a nursing home, did not make a move to find anything alternative.
Right.
So we don't know what was put before the judge, but if a proper case is brought by the legal proceedings, civil proceedings, the judge doesn't have much wiggle room. The judge perhaps can give an order for possession that takes effect months down the road, but certainly the justice of the case has to be balanced by the judge.
Right.
Where there are competing rights, and to perhaps give some time if all of these facts were brought to the attention of the judge. We don't know. But I just want to back up by saying that nursing homes are supposed to be registered.
Yes.
The registration process. Yes. And they have to be inspected by the Ministry of Health, registered through the Ministry of Health, and therefore be official. So if it is an official nursing home, that operator could have reached out to the ministry for help in seeking alternative location or some bargaining.
Right.
And certainly there is also the Jamaican Council for Persons with Disabilities.
Right.
That could be approached for persons who may be in the home who have disabilities for some kind of intervention, to see if the matter can be resolved without some kind of eviction of those persons.
But while you put it on the owner, and some of them really are probably, I'm not saying anything about that particular person, but some of them should never be running a home. I'm just saying that the system, and that's why I don't believe you must put the judges in boxes too, you know. The judge should be able to either to say something they call an arbiter dicta, or say in a case like this, the law should allow me to broker the agency to have the person to move to another place. But I think government is one government. And what ought to happen, he should probably be able to give a directive or what have you to say to another government agency, take charge of these persons. Because they can't help themselves. We can't just throw them out like that. We just, that's what we can't, they did. But you shouldn't just throw them out like that. So I'm not blaming the judge as such, you know. But I'm just saying, well, the only thing I say, he ought to be aware of the circumstances. It's just a matter of just looking at the law and therefore I make a decision. Because nowadays you look at the circumstances, you look what is involved. You say when you get all what is criminal in front of you, you hear why he did so and so, where, and look at the mitigating factors and so on. And then some of us will say, because we are best, you know, say if we were all criminal, I would have probably given 5 years to 10. But these are some elderly persons who are thinking of them. That's the problem that I have. And I'm thinking that as a lawyer, I think that's Vernon Derby.
We don't know what took place in the case before the actual judge. But judges on a daily basis have to balance the rights of the parties and to make sure that justice is done for both sides. So one would expect that to be done in the instant case. But we don't have all the facts here, so it's hard to come down and say some kind of injustice was done. But certainly owner and operator at that home could have reached out to the Ministry of Health and other bodies that exist that could have offered some help. But we don't know all the facts, so that's
right.
The problem.
And another problem I have, like, I'm different. Well, you probably know this. But when something comes to my attention, I'll hold on to it for the next 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 years. In Jamaica, it is news today. Tomorrow, it is history.
Yes, that is how the media, one aspect of the media operates. They have to keep themselves current. And the things that become stale, they move on and oftentimes do not come back to it.
Right.
Yes.
You notice overseas, though, you know, I watch CNN sometimes, and let me tell you something, they'll run a story for it. There are some stories that have been running for probably years, they don't come off it at all. They don't.
Yeah, that is so. It depends on the culture of and how the media operates.
Oh, guess what?
Media needs the money, so they have to...
Really?
Attention.
Guess what? They say money is the root of all evil, but people don't understand why. I have to go to when the light trouble. Time is on us. Thank you, my friend. Have a wonderful day.
Yeah.
All the best. Bye-bye. Okay.